I'm Lucy, and in this second part video, I'm going to show you a hand trick to find those exact trig values that you need to know. So the angles from part one were 0, 30, 45, 60, and 90. We're going to use those same angles, but a different trick this time, rather than that table of values. Take either hand with your palm facing towards you, and label your little finger as 0 degrees, your ring finger as 30, middle one is 45, 60, and your thumb is 90 degrees. To make this work, you just need to remember to square root the number of fingers and divide by 2. So if we wanted sine 30, we'd bend down our 30 degree finger, and you just have your baby finger underneath. So sine 30 is square root 1 divided by 2, because there's only one finger underneath, which simplifies to a half. If we wanted sine 90 degrees, you'd bend down your 90 degree thumb, and so you have 4 fingers underneath. So sine 90 is square root of 4 divided by 2, which simplifies to 1. What would sine 60 be? Work out the answer and click here when you're ready to check. Did you get square root 3 divided by 2? For cos, we just count the fingers above instead of the ones below. So for cos 60, bend down your 60 finger and count the fingers above, 1. So cos 60 is square root 1 divided by 2, which simplifies to a half. What would cos 90 be? Work out the answer and click here when you're ready to check. Did you get 0 degrees? Bend down your 90 degree thumb and there are no fingers above. So root 0 divided by 2 is 0. And finally, tan. For tan, we still count fingers, but there is just one extra little twist. The same as for sine and cos, bend down the angle finger. So let's find tan 60. Let's bend down our 60 degree finger, and we've got 1 cosine finger above and 3 sine fingers below. For tan, we flip our hand over and we have 3 sine fingers above and the 1 cosine below. So tan is square root fingers over square root fingers. So square root 3 over square root 1, which simplifies to root 3. What would tan 30 be? Work out the answer and click here when you're ready to check. Did you get square root 1 divided by square root 3? Which would simplify to 1 over root 3. So there we have a really easy way of remembering those exact values. We use our hand, the special angles 0, 30, 45, 60, and 90, and just remember, for sine and cos, it's root fingers divided by 2. Sine is root fingers below the bent finger, and cos is root finger above the bent finger. And for tan, you just flip it over, and it's root fingers divided by root fingers.